Wound management is an holistic approach to the management of a wound, and involves looking at the whole patient as opposed to simply the hole in the patient. Wound management has a number of different components, and includes a thorough clinical assessment, includes also all diagnostics pertinent to the wound, and also includes all of the therapeutic interventions, but also includes focus on prevention and prognosis and the prognostic implications of wounds, both from the standpoint of what that wound entails in terms of the patient's overall survival, but also what are the odds that this wound is going to heal and patient be able to restore their usual level of functioning. It's important to note that what underpins successful wound management is an interprofessional approach to care, and also promoting integration both vertically and horizontally within the healthcare system. And wound management in its most fulsome way cannot be achieved without having interprofessional collaboration, because essentially one healthcare discipline cannot deal with all of the issues around a patient with a wound. Wounds, just like palliative care overall, needs the integration and the involvement of multiple different disciplines, not only simply physicians and nurses, but also aspects around PT, OT, nutrition therapy, etc. So successful wound management is predicated on an interprofessional approach to care and a whole patient approach to care, as opposed to simply focusing on the local issues. Wounds are the area and domain within palliative care with the greatest unmet needs. It is somewhat of an orphan domain, and it's orphaned essentially because the amount of education around wounds is so deficient. Most medical schools have essentially no curriculum component around wounds, and hence the deficiencies that we see in clinical practice countrywide, and for that matter worldwide. It has become orphaned, and initially it became more of a nursing concern, and the socialization of physicians at medical schools was that wounds were nursing issues. And I think that's how the term wound care evolved, because wound care became, the connotation of wound care became to focus simply on the dressing issues. So what is the optimal dressing that we fill the wound with or cover the wound with? And we are now recognizing that dealing with a wound goes far beyond simply the dressing. And also the fact that there's been so much focus on the dressing to cover the wound and to cloak it, so to speak, we've forgotten about the macro. We've forgotten about what exists behind the dressing, which is not just a major systemic issue, because after all, the skin is the body's largest organ. There's a live person behind that wound. Right. And the suffering that a wound produces is it really epitomizes multidimensional suffering. There's so much suffering, and it's not the wound, it's the patient that suffers. So we need to focus on not just the wound, but the patient with the wound, and recognize that wounds cause suffering not just on a physical level. Mind you, they do cause a tremendous amount of suffering on a physical level. They produce a multitude of symptoms, most notably pain, odor, exudates, itching, bleeding, aesthetic concerns, etc. But beyond that, they cause a lot of secondary psychosocial, existential, spiritual, and other such issues, which reduce people's quality of life and people's well-being. And thus, the healthcare team, the interprofessional healthcare team, needs to acknowledge that it goes the suffering that wounds produce go far beyond the physical symptoms, which in themselves are huge, but yet there's much more than just physical symptoms that allow wounds to generate tremendous amounts of suffering in the true sense of the word. We can never forget that we're dealing with a patient, not just with a wound. we need to counsel patients, we need to tell them what we're doing, and we need to empower them, and essentially we need to warn them that there may be a little bit of discomfort or some degree of discomfort associated with the very maneuvers that we're doing to try to assist the care of their wound. And it's important to, again, it speaks more to the art and craft of healthcare rather than the science of healthcare. Being gentle with patients, not just with our actions, but also with our words and counseling, and also creating an environment that is conducive, making sure that the temperature of the room is appropriate for the patient and their privacy is being respected, and we're doing everything with informed consent as well.